Hello friends and everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. In this video, we're going to talk about how we can deploy our static application, which is Blazor WebAssembly app, on the cloud server that we are working on. You know, in the previous videos, we've seen how we can deploy our web API, make it run, connect to a database. And as I speak, our database is active, our API is also active, and now they are both live. We can access them anywhere using the IP with the specific port that we implemented in the other videos. And that's great. That's amazing. Yeah, so we have this implemented nicely. Now, the next thing that we're going to be doing is we want to create a Blazor app. And now this Blazor app, you want to consume this API because, you know, in the real world, when you have a static app, definitely going to have backend, isn't it? So the back end, the front end is going to drive the back end. So it means when we create our static app, we need to connect it to our API, and I'll make sure it gets what it needs to run. You know, in our API that we created as a demo project, we have in a product API, which returns a CRUD operation. So I'm going to be using only get. We're going to retrieve all the products from the API, and we're going to consume that in our static application, which is Blazor WebAssembly. After that, we're going to publish this and I'll move this into the IIS and on our cloud server to make sure this is also running. Remember that when we are buying the domain, we use a name for that, and that name is reserved now. We did not use that for the API because we bought only one, so we want to be using that for the static app. Okay, I bought mine at netcodehub.in, and I believe you bought yours too. Now, in our API, let's say when I go to get product from the cloud server, so this is my server here. Now, maybe I can run that on local machine, and that's my local machine. So I can refresh it, and I go to product, test this out, and see the number of products that I do have in my API. So if I share my screen, you can see that here I have, I think, only one record in it. And that is what we're going to be using here. But now we have only one record. We can also add more records. So let's add two or more records attached to what we have already. Indeed, we have four records here, as you can see from the screen. Great. Now let's go and create our static app so we can drive from this API. Now, when we open your Blazor or the Visual Studio, you make sure that the studio that you have opened, you're in an admin mode. So I have created just a demo one, demo Blazor WebAssembly app, and I believe you know how to create this. Great. Now, in that, I created just already have this home component. So I injected our HTTP client, which is already registered in the program.cs file. So when you check from our program, we have HTTP client already registered. So I am using that. And now in here, I am making an API call. I created this product. Now, that is a model that we have over here. It is what we use on our API. So check here, we have ID name, quantity, and a category ID. That is what our API is returning. So let me open the API again, and I'll see the models. We have an ID, category is null. We have name, quantity, and a category ID. So we're picking this for properties. And when we look at this, we have them here. So in our home.razor, you see we are getting that. So there's an address of that, and now this is going to run to get it. Now there is the local one, so I tested this out and both work. So currently we don't need this one. Now we make sure that we this is live, and indeed it is. So we're going to call that. We can put a breakpoint or whatever. Now, when you check here, we are looping through the list, as you can see from here. We say if product's not equal to null, that is, I want to create this container with a row. And I loop through the list that we have, create individual column auto, that is a card, and also set the header, the name, the quantity, and the category ID, at least. so that we can know that, hey, this is getting from the API. So we have this implemented beautifully here. Great. Now we're going to run this and I'll see whether our service is going to call. Then we see how we can also deploy this onto our server to make it live. So you can also access this site from your machine. Let's run it. So the API or the Blazor application is running. And I'm going to have a look with the home page. We are having four products from our API. And there you go. You get it. So now is the time for us to deploy this onto our server so we can access it without using this local host. So let's close this. And we're going to publish this to folder as usual. Same thing applies to how we did that with it with the API. So I'm going to close this. Let's go to solution. And then you can right click on the Blazor, go to publish. Let's use a folder for now. We want to choose folder for this. Then I think I have folder, I have profile already created. Well, I can create another one, then choose folder for this. And in that, that is going to, we're going to have, we can see that from the bin, and that's okay. So I'm going to finish that and then close it. Show all settings. And I make sure that it's in a release mode so it can be in a production. Self-contained, and that's self-contained Blazor assembly. So for this, we don't need to do any settings here. Leave it as default and then click on save it. And then let's click on publish to get this project published. Oh, so it is finished. Now, when you see, we have the published files in a specific folder from the release. So we can just hit on the control key and now click on the link, which is going to open directly to where the files are. So that is it. We got it, right? Now we can go back to Blazor Wasm. Let's grab this. And on the server, let's go and paste this. I've copied this. You must also do save. Let's minimize that. This is our server. You see, I'm connected with my IP address. And in here, let's paste it on the desktop. Let's wait for all this to finish. Then we're going to continue on with the next setup. So this is done. And now when you check the desktop, you see we have it here. Let's rename this folder. And now this is Blazor Wasm. And we're going to move this folder from this location to our local Dex inet pub. Now this folder, you get it as soon as you install IIS. Go to www.roots and then let's paste this folder here. So maybe I have these two folders. I'm going to delete the previous one. Let's do this again. Okay, so that is the folder that I have here. And if I open it, it is what we have. From the www.root, we have everything from our published project. Okay, let's launch our IIS. So just hit on the window key IIS. You have it, you open that. And then from here, we're going to add site. So on our server, click on that, add site. Let's right click on this, then add website. Then site name, that is our Blazor Wasm. Then from the application pool, just click on select, choose the default. And then from physical path, let's go and choose the folder. So let's go to inetpub, Blazor, www.root, then go for Blazor Wasm, click on OK. And then IP address, you make sure you choose this, the IP address of this server. And then the port is going to be 80, like HTTP port 80. That's okay. Now the host name, let's have Netcode-Hub. Mine is Netcode-Hub.in. That is the domain that I bought. And do remember, you bought yours. So I'm going to put yours here. Then we can click on. Okay. Now, when you are done, click on the same Blazor wasm. You have it over here. And then you go to bindings. So we have Netcode-Hub.in. Let's add another one. And here, you choose this. I want to say www.netcodehub.in. The same port of 80. We are doing that so that when a user accesses without passing on the www, it works. And also when he passes on www, it also will work. Okay. So we have that. Then let's close it. So now that we have this app created, this art created, you can just choose the Blazor. Well, this is a Blazor wasm. And then I can go to maybe restart and then browse this. So let's check it up and see in our browser. I'm clicking on that. Let's see. Okay, so it's opening here. And I can see, yeah, we have it. I think it's open twice. But when you run that and having an issue, you need to install hosting bundle. So if you haven't already installed this, come to this link and I'll put this in the video description. Then click on this .NET Core Hosting Bundle to get it installed and then run that. Follow the result to install that. And then you see from here, we have this working. So Netcode-Hub.in. Now this is working on the server. So let's go to our local machine. This is my local machine. And then let me just paste this here. Let's see whether it will work. Oh, yeah, we are in. So I am passing on without specifying the www, right? Now with the same thing, I'm going to do www dot. Then I'm going to pass in netcode-hub.in. Now let's see whether this is also going to open. Yes, and it has opened because of how we configure that. And when it opens, go to the home. You can see we have this product being received from the API. You can try this domain from your end and it's still going to work. You're going to see this. I'll make this live for a while before I take it out. Okay, later on, I'm going to have a proper site built with this domain. That's great. Okay, so that is what we have in here. That's amazing, isn't it? And that is it, guys. So we've seen how we can also publish our Blazor WebAssembly, which is our front end, on the same server, which is running our API. So our API and our client, that's a back end and front end, both are running nicely, and they are also connected, right? So we can receive them, or we can access this outside our local system. That's amazing. So that is it, guys. I believe for now you have no issue with deployment. And in case you're doing and you have an issue too, then do let me know and I'll be available and to assist you and take you through. All right, so I believe you enjoyed this as I did as well. If you did so, then give me a thumbs up for this video and subscribe to this channel if you haven't done that. And stay tuned for more content like this. Until then, take care and see you again.